name is Nori Harris Castaneda, and I am an HIV test counselor and a transgender identified person with the Billy DeFrank LGBT Center of Silicon Valley. Society teaches us that gender only consists of two things, which is male and female. My experience has taught me that there are more stops in the way between what is true male and what is true female. Yeah. So a transgender person is distinctive because they have a greater awareness that the gender that they were assigned at birth is not necessarily the one that they can identify with currently. To me, gender identity means it's relating to how the person feels internally. Our society has different roles and things that are already pretty much dictated for us upon our birth. And transgender people are known to not be comfortable with the norms of being a true male or a true female. Gender and sex to me are different because you have a biological sex. That's a physical characteristic of what someone is born with. When a baby's born, the first thing they do is look between its legs and say if it's a boy or a girl. Those are the only two choices. So that's biological sex. Gender is an internal thing, which is known to be inside of someone's mind, which can influence a whole bunch of things. Some people are willing to express their gender identity, even if it's the opposite of what they were born into, and others don't have that confidence. For the most part, I would say that the media exposure that we have had lately, and I'm saying within the last 3 years, for the most part, has been more on the positive side. Prior to that, it pretty much was all negative. Any TV show, any news show, would always perpetuate the perception that transgender identified people were perverts, deviants, abnormal, abominations, all these negative connotations. But lately, we have had some more positive types of press. Generally still, when a transgender identified person does make it into the headlines, there's usually some sensationalism in regards to who the person used to be, rather than addressing who the person is now. The early part was a lot of negativity. A lot of negativity and a lot of fear when they would threaten things would happen to this certain type of person, specifically transgender. So that was a tough one, especially being raised as a Catholic. There was a lot of internal conflicts, but as I became an adult and started interacting with more people and started widening my view of the world, I got to see different things, and that helped me become the person who I am today. We do have a few religious institutions, churches. MCC, Metropolitan Community Church, is LGBT friendly. They do have transgender identified pastors. So not only do transgender identified people feel welcome in their space, and there's also a couple of Catholic churches that I can't remember right off the bat, I'm sorry, that do have Catholic LGBT support, because there are people who are still, you know, strong in their faith and don't feel that they have to lose it in order to express themselves as their true selves. It's very, very prevalent, the belief in the transgender community, that because we are different, and because there's so much negativity perpetuated towards us, there are those who work harder to fight against that stigma and discrimination, and then there are also others who are just glad to be a part of a religious type of organization. Transition process. They leave their home. Sometimes they leave their family behind, and they move somewhere else and start fresh. I was one of the luckier ones where I didn't have to do that. I put up with a lot of my negativity as a child. So as far as I was concerned, when I became an adult, it couldn't have gotten any worse. So 13 years later into transition, I haven't gone anywhere. The community is still here, and the community is actually growing and thriving too. Once again, just have an open mind and an open heart if you can. We are raised to put labels on things and to put categories and boxes for people. And sometimes we're wrong on those assessments that we make. But if you have an open mind and a higher awareness, and just a little bit is all that's needed, that can open up things and change things for them. Just try to read up on LGBT issues if you can. We do have a growing presence politically as well as in the community itself. We are increasing in numbers, and a lot of it that has to do with the availability of information that's out there. The younger kids in elementary school as well as middle school still have a limited access to LGBT information, and I understand that, you know, because, well, the perception is that, well, they're kids and they're very influential or very easily influenced at that time. And I can understand some of the fears, but on the other hand, in elementary school, in middle school, is when the problems usually start. And in order to keep on ignoring them, can cause a lot of bad things to happen as opposed to being open and aware of things. We do have political involvement from the federal level all the way down to the local level all over the United States. So we are, as a community, building and becoming more integrated as well as a part of society, as opposed to always being on the outskirts of it. But then transgender, it's a whole other category, because even within our transgender community, you can have a transgender gay man, or you can have a lesbian transsexual woman. So it can be kind of confusing for some people.
Yeah.
But as long as you maintain that openness and just maintain the fact that people as human beings have a gender identity, which is how they feel on the inside, a sexual orientation, which is who they're attracted to, and a biological sex, which is what they're physically dealing with. A lot of health issues have come up for transgender people, and a lack of understanding from medical community perpetuates a lot of the negativity and stigma. So one of the things we're working towards as a community too is having better healthcare access, because we do have a medical condition which is in need of some treatment and therapy and sometimes surgery. And rather than feel unwelcome in a medical care setting, we're working towards having it be more inclusive and more accommodating, because because people come in all different shapes, sizes, and colors. Transgender people do as well, too, even more so in some cases. What's unique about the transgender community that I feel is that because of who we are and how we see things, naturally we have a higher awareness because we know what we were, we have an idea of what we want to be, but we're also currently aware of what we're working with in the current time as well too. I wouldn't necessarily call it a change. If anything, at a minimum, just to be a little bit more open-minded and to have a higher awareness of how people really are as opposed to what someone might say about a different type of person. As far as change goes, I know we have a long way to go. I allow myself to be a little bit more open and a higher awareness. I can have a better understanding of the individual that I might be working with at the time, as opposed to imposing my conditioning, my upbringing on this person. I make myself open to the people as well as the community that I work with. So just a little bit of open-mindedness and some open hearts would be helpful too.